Good evening everyone. Welcome back to another session. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about the different types of parasites based on the interaction between the host and the parasite. We have learned about ectoparasites, monogenetic parasites, digenetic parasites and endoparasites. So the last type of parasite is the hyperparasite. So hyperparasite is a parasite which lives in or on the body of another parasite. So example of hyperparasite is Nosema notabilis, which lives in Spirospora polymorpha, which in turn lives in the urinary bladder of toadfish. So here Nosema notabilis is the hyperparasite, Spirospora is the parasite, whereas toadfish is the host. In the fish, in the urinary bladder of the toadfish, Spirospora polymorpha lives as the parasite, whereas Nosema notabilis lives as a parasite in Spirospora polymorpha. So the type of host, the first type of host are the primary host or the definitive host. The host in which the parasite undergoes sexual reproduction is known as the primary host. Man is the primary host for Eucararia bancrofti. This means that the sexual reproduction of this Eucararia bancrofti occurs in man. And another example is female Anopheles mosquito. So female Anopheles mosquito for Plasmodium. So the life cycle of the sexual stage of Plasmodium occurs in female Anopheles mosquito. So female Anopheles mosquito and man are the primary host. So second type of host are the intermediate host or the secondary host. The host that harbors the larval or immature or asexual reproduction of the parasite is known as the intermediate or secondary host. So example for intermediate or secondary host is man for Plasmodium. Man acts as the secondary host for Plasmodium, whereas Culex mosquito acts as the host for Eucararia bancrofti. The third type of host are the reservoir hosts. So the host that carries the infective stages of a parasite in its body in the absence of the main host. So when the main host is absent, this reservoir host will carry the infective stage of the parasite, but no development occurs in the reservoir host. No, there is no development and it will not cause the disease. So it is just residing. So the reservoir host is just giving shelter to the parasite. So example for reservoir host is monkey for Plasmodium and African antelope for Trypanosoma gambiense.